Hello everyone, in this video let's have a look at the LG V30 Pixel Experience 12.1 ROM, and this is based out of Android version 12 and it also has the latest Android security patch level as of now. So this is the home screen as you can see here, and here are a few customization options. As you can see here, you can change the wallpaper and style pretty quickly, and as you can see it changed. It takes a few seconds but it does the job. And here are further settings regarding the customization options, and these are pretty cool. So let's dive in a bit further. As you can see here, you can change the grid size, and apart from that you also have the option for basic colors, so you can change the color tone basically. And as you can see here, it changed. So these customization settings are pretty cool. So let's go in further, and these are the usual settings that you would find in a Pixel launcher, nothing out of the ordinary or any special features. And do note that I'm using the inbuilt screen recorder. And here we go. As you can see here, there are a lot of custom tiles and you have a lot of stuff. But talking about screen recording, I had a few issues in terms of screen recording with this particular ROM. I used a third-party app which worked on all other ROMs, but here it started giving me issues where it would get killed while I was recording. And here's the power menu, as you could see. And even with the inbuilt screen recorder, sometimes the inbuilt audio is recorded and the second time it was not recorded, so it may be a bit finicky. As you can see here, these are the customization settings that you would find here, and you can edge long swipe action is some of the things that you could take here. And you can customize and hide the gesture indicator in case that is annoying to you, and you can even customize the sensitivity here. So, and also the edge touch area. So in some apps like Discord where you have to use the swipe feature, these gestures could get annoying, and this is where this customization comes in handy. Here's the one-handed mode, but I do not use this, so I'll just skip it. And here is the power menu option, and you can also use hold for assistant and customize what is shown in the shortcuts of the power menu. Let's dive in further, and you also have the option to swipe to take screenshot, and I love this feature. And as you can see here, after taking the screenshot, you have the option to directly share or edit here. And as you can see here, the performance is pretty fast. However, I do feel that the battery life was a bit better on Android 11, but I guess that is a trade-off you have to make for better performance. But overall, I'm still pretty happy with battery life. It isn't that bad, but definitely if it's battery life that is your main concern, for now I would stick with Android 11 ROMs. And as you can see here, you can control the playback and you can even take partial screenshots. And there were a host of options there. So let's go back out and see what other stuff we have. As you can see here, I took a screenshot using the power button and the volume down button. So that is another option that you can use for taking a screenshot. And here you have network traffic monitor under the status bar settings. And I really love this feature, and I like a ROM which has this particular feature, because you know, I can get an idea of speed at which my ROMs are downloading. And here is the clock position. And do know that since this is a Pixel Experience ROM, Google Apps come inbuilt, but you do need to separately flash Magisk. And you can auto hide or change the battery style status, like showing the percentage or making it a circle. And as you can see here, you can drag down from the right to quickly show the quick settings. And here is the screen lock options. And it even has the face unlock, which is pretty great because not all ROM have it. And here there are some settings tucked away. As you can see here, under lock screen, under display section, you have always show time and info. It's basically always on display. So that is hidden away there. And if you like to use double tap to wake, make sure that you go into the settings and enable that at the bottom in the display settings, because it is turned off by default. So that's pretty much it for this video. If you liked it, click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel for more such videos. I'll see you in my next video. Take care. Bye-bye.